What's up? Are you good? This is AS Clément Baking Channel. No. I decided to bake a cake today. On the basis that Becky has been asking me to bake a cake since I made my cheesecake, and she's been asking me to do a coffee and walnut cake. Now, I'm not going to eat it in this video because I don't like coffee and walnut cake. Secondly, I don't like the coffee and walnut cake that I've made. So, I am just going to walk through everything I did to make this cake. My mum likes it and Becky likes it. So it's safe to assume that it's nice. I just think it's a little bit grim because it's coffee and walnut. Who the fuck likes coffee and walnut in a cake? Anyway, without further ado, let's get into baking a cake. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is add 2 tablespoons of coffee into a like a jug, and then you're going to want to add 180 milliliters of water to it. Stir. Now, this recipe has been taken from the BBC Good Food Recipe webpage. I may put a link to it in the description if I remember. If not, I don't know what I'm going to do. Now, you're going to want to take, let me find 85 grams of walnuts. Now, 2 tablespoons are going to be roughly chopped. That is to my left hand side. And the rest is going to be finely chopped, which is what I'm doing currently. Don't worry, my knife skills are excellent. As you can probably tell, you know, top chefers. It all goes horribly wrong at some point in this video anyway. So make sure you grease. It says 2 20-centimeter tins. I actually don't have 2 tins, I have 1 large one. So accommodate for that as you would. I had to just wing it and guess. I think instead of taking like 25 to 30 minutes, it took like 50 minutes in the end because it's a very large tin. Next, you're going to want to beat the butter, flour, sugar, baking powder, eggs and vanilla extract, and half of the coffee mixture that you've made into a bowl. So we added 280 grams of self-raising flour, 250 grams of softened butter. I put it in the oven to try and soften it up a bit, which melted the outside and the inside was still hard. Probably one of the reasons the cake went wrong. 250 grams of caster sugar, half a teaspoon of and you're going to want your girlfriend to break 4 eggs in the thing for you while you put in your vanilla extract. You want 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract and 4 eggs. Now, Becky starts off very well here. We break 1 egg. Very nice indeed. I'm happy with that. She goes off piste, absolutely fucking thumps the gun. And that one went very well. She grabs the third one. Oh shit, a little bit of egg went in that. A little bit of shell. And then you're going to want to spend the rest of the time. It says 4 eggs. I'm not sure that we actually ended up putting 3 or 4 in the end. Looking at that, I think I went a bit mad at her and just was like fuming. You're going to want to whisk it until the butter hits the side of your hand mixer. it was a fun recipe. It was late at night. I just wanted to get it done because Becky has been badgering me for it and I was knackered after working so long. But you're going to want to put the mixture into your tin, which is very nice. Obviously, put the coffee in as well. We've put half the coffee in. The other half is meant to go on the cake at the end. I didn't actually end up putting it on the cake in the end because it was already dark enough. And it was stupidly moist anyway, so I don't see... I didn't really see the reason of adding more coffee to it. It already tasted like coffee. I sort of think that it was a bit of a waste. Anyway, put it all into that. And, yeah, put it in the oven. It says 25 to 30 minutes. If you've got 1 large baking tin, put it in for like 50 minutes. Anyway. Am I done yet? No. Okay, so turns out this clip is going to go on for a little bit of a while. I do apologise. Make sure you've got all of your cake tin. Smooth it out. That's one of the best things you can do, smoothing it out. Oh, I've missed simple steps. I have. That's why this clip's long. So, the walnuts. I didn't read the recipe properly and I forgot to add the chopped walnuts into the actual mixture. And so I read the bit where it says scatter the rough chopped walnuts over one of the cakes. So I grabbed the fine stuff, the ones that we chopped really finely, and poured it over thinking that was the right stuff. It turns out it wasn't. Wait for it. He grabs it in a second. He looks at his phone. What do we have to do? Reads the wrong instructions. Oh, I grabbed these and I pour them on top. I then obviously realised I've done it wrong, so we do end up mixing it in the tin, which probably didn't help things, which is probably why it stuck to the these in the thicker pieces. Come on, lad. There we go. I tried to spread them out a bit, put these to the side. I thought, let's dress it up at the end. Didn't do that anyway. And I was like, right, let's try and mix these in delicately. And then I thought, wait, we're only going to mix them in anyway. Let's just give it a good old thwacketh, daggeth, mix them in really quick. And then we can smoothen it over again. It's only butter on the bottom. What harm can that do? So, there we go, mixed in relatively well. Obviously not brilliantly well, but just enough so it stays where it is and doesn't sink to the bottom. Give it a couple of taps, give it a couple of whacks. Bing, bang, bong, and we're done. That's all mixed in very nicely, smoothed over, get round the edges. Make sure there's not enough in the middle, because otherwise it rises like in the middle, which it did end up doing anyway. But come on, lad, come on, hurry up, what are you playing at? Put that in the bowl, wipe your hands clean, grab the rest of the roughly chopped walnut, should I say, and scatter them on top, nice and pretty. Which, come to think about it, when I got the cake out of the oven, there wasn't too many of these on top, so they've obviously sank into the cake. Which is the stupidest of recipes that I followed. Anyway. We digress. As the guy on Call of Duty Zombies would have said, I digress. Come on, lad. We get it. You're putting walnuts on a cake. This has been the longest step so far. We finally make it into the filling. There we go. So, for the filling, not that we used it as an actual filling, because like I said, we didn't have two cakes, we had one, so I just used it as a topping. You want to grab the icing sugar. You need 100 grams of icing sugar. It says sifted, plus a little extra for dusting. I didn't sift any of this, because why not? Instead, I've now got biceps and triceps and forearms for days, but only on the right-hand side of my body, because I was using my right hand to mix, and my God, were we whisking this for a fucking long time. I couldn't be bothered to use the electric mixer, because I used it in a jug, and I realised it wouldn't have, fit, so couldn't I had to use a whisk. You then grab some 150ml of double cream. Very nice indeed. Look at me go. Use my little weigher. And then you're also going to want to use room temperature mascarpone. Mascarpone cheese. What's the old joke? What you call a horse with a hat on? Mascarpone. Anyway, moving on, you put that in. Come on. Let me grab it out. Give it a few seconds. I was trying to sort the weighing scales out. There we go, mascarpone. This went everywhere, by the way. Who the fuck uses mascarpone cheese anywhere other than in a cake? Fuck me, it was a pain in the arse. It was hard to find it. It was hard to fucking... It made no difference as far as I'm aware. You're then going to want to whisk. When I decide I want to whisk, I think this whisking clip is going to take about a year. Come on, lad. Hang all day. No, he's just moved out of the camera shot. La-di-da-di-da. Come on, mate, what are you doing? There we go. We stop whisking it. And when I say whisk, I mean give it a... this isn't sped up. Look how fast my arm's moving. Look how tense I am. I am fucking eating this. And best believe it took so long. It took all the effort out. I thought, oh, it'll only take about 2 minutes. Nah, fuck that shit. It took about half hour. It took about as long as the cake took to bake. Jesus. Do you know the worst part is, I got halfway through doing this, lads. I've just walked off now. Halfway through doing this, I ended up washing the pots because my arms were in. Washing the pots, came back and whisked the rest of it. Come on, come back, there we go. I think I started talking to my mum. Can't whisk again, beat it from side to side, go on, get a whizzle. It is getting thicker, to be fair, I'm quite proud of myself. Oh, he's fucked off again. Oh, baking with Luke. You can't go wrong, can you? Oh. What have we done here then? Oh, Chelsea kick off in half hour. That's nice. Come back, Luke. Come on. Come on, Luke. There we go. He's back. Look, he's whisking it. See? It's just as liquid. Didn't really get much thicker than this, if I'm being totally honest. But also, I completely forgot a step. What step? what step did you forget? I forgot to add the coffee into the fucking cream. So, coming up in a few seconds time for you guys is me adding coffee to the cream. And 3, 2, 1. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Right, we're back at this. I forgot to add the coffee. So let's add the coffee in. There we go. 2 tablespoons of that. That's all we needed. Now, I tried to fold it in until I realised if you're adding more liquid into what's hopefully a thick cream mixture, it goes back to being a liquid. Isn't that fun? So as you can tell, it's actually a lot thicker here than it was earlier. I'd been whipping this for a good, like, 20 to 30 minutes. Oh, I should have just used the electric whisk in the end. I don't know why I didn't. My arm's still hurting today. And this is the day after I made it. Biceps for days, boys. Biceps for days. I folded it in. Decided, you know what? It's not working. Let's whip it again. Give the whisk. I washed the whisk and then I had to get it back out. So I had to dry it. Threw it around the edge just to clean it. And there we go. Mixing it again. It's gone back to a liquid. But it is getting much, much thicker a lot quicker. It's getting thicker quicker. There we go. So look at me. Power wrist this. Jesus Christ. Go on, lad. I'm watching myself whisk. You know, you can't get any more like it. I'm breaking the third wall here, talking to myself. I'm talking about myself. To you guys, hey. And the narrator said, go on, lad. Anyway, I got up towards the end of the video anyway. Anyway, let's do some trigger sounds. And the whisk is done. That's only because trust me when I say that, like, a bit broke off the bottom, but that was the only bit that broke off. It's only like a centimeter. It looks loads on this. It's not big at all, and I'm well happy. It actually, like, the cake itself turned out really well, but I just don't like the taste of it, so that's why I won't eat it. Like I say, eventually we get this thick creamy mixture on top, pat it down the sides, decorate the cake, smoothen it out on top. I realised that I put it all in the middle and tried to push it to the edge, but that caused there to be none in the middle. Oh no. There we go, so I sort of push it around like that, and then I end up with actually no mixture in the middle, so I end up pushing it back up towards the top in a few seconds time. I'm not sure whether I do like a reveal of the cake or not. I think I do. Like I say, we have no more walnuts for the cake, so I don't know what more I can do. I can't add any. Oh, that's the kitchen service fucked again. There we go, look. I really didn't want it to go down the sides. I don't know why. Fuck it. And then messed up there, look, on the left. Anyway. Lego. Beautiful cake. Anyway. Yeah, so the cake actually turned out okay, as far as I'm aware. I just don't know the taste of it. This has just been me telling a story of me